Hello, BookTube. I'm back for the March of the Poems, as well as Poetry Thursday, which is the greatest day on BookTube. I want to apologize. I missed yesterday's video, not out of choice, but because Tuesday night I was just hit really hard with flu bug. It knocked me under. I thought that death surely was knocking on the door because it was just, I couldn't imagine being more miserable. And yesterday was spent recovering and not doing much of anything at all, other than what was absolutely necessary to keep up with the kids. And unfortunately, my wife had the same thing at the same time. And we've vowed never to let that happen ever again. It sucks. So today I'm coming back at you with two poems to make up for missing yesterday, both by Joe Haldeman. This morning I was reading a short story by Joe Haldeman from the Old Venus anthology. And the very first page and a half in there was a little biography about Joe Haldeman, and it mentioned in there that he was an award-winning poet and a pretty accomplished poet. And so that immediately made me sit up, take attention, and wonder, can I find anything by Joe Haldeman that he has written for poetry? And if so, I was going to read it today, and surely I was able to do that. So the first one we have here is called Forever Peace. Men stop war to make gods sometimes, peace gods, who would make earth a haven, a place for men to think and love and play. No war to cloud their minds and hearts. Stop, somehow, men from being men. Gods make war to stop men from becoming gods. Without the beat of drums to stop our ears, what heaven we could make of earth. The anchor that is war left behind, somehow free to stop war. Gods make men to be somewhat like them, so men express their godliness in war. To take life, this is what the gods do, not the womanly urge to make life, nor the simple sense to stop. War make men gods. To stop these gods from raging, we have to find the heart and head to make new gods, who don't take men and human sacrifice, new gods, who find disgust in war. Gods stop. To make men war for their amusement, we can stop their fun. We can make new gods in human guise. No need to call to heaven. Just take plain men and show them to the heaven they could make. To stop God's wars, men make their own destiny. We don't need war to prove to anyone that we are men. But even that is not enough. To stop war, we have to become more. To stop war, we have to become gods. To stop war, make men gods. And then the award-winning poem, Saul's Death. I used to be a monk, but gave it over before books and prayer and studies cooled my blood, and joined with Richard as a mercenary soldier. No Richard that you'd heard of, just a man who'd bought a title for his name, and it was in his service I met Saul. The first day of my service I liked Saul. His easy humor quickly won me over. He confided Saul was not his name. He'd taken up another name for blood, as had I. My fighting name was just a word we used at home for a private soldier. I felt at home as mercenary soldier. I liked the company of men like Saul, though most of Richard's men were just fighting for the bounty of when it's over. I loved the clash of weapons, splashing blood. I lived the meager promise of my name. Saul promised that he'd tell me his real name when we were through playing as a soldier. I said the same. We took an oath in blood. But I would never know him but as Saul. He'd die before the long campaign was over, dying for a cause that was not just. Only fools require a cause that's just. Fools and children to make a name. Now I've had 60 years to think it over, 60 years of being no one's soldier. 60 years since Broadsword opened Saul and splashed my body with his precious blood. But damn, we lived for bodies and for blood. The reek of dead men rotting, it was just a sweet perfume for those like me and Saul. My peaceful language doesn't have a name for lewd delight in going off to soldier. It hurts my heart sometimes to know it's over. My heart was hard as stone when it was over, and finally I'd had my fill of blood and knew I was too old to be a soldier. Nothing left for me to do but just go back home and make myself a name in ways of peace. Forgetting war and Saul, in ways of blood he made himself a name, though he was just a mercenary soldier. I loved Saul before it was all over. A mercenary soldier has no future, Some say his way of life is hardly human, but we did have our own small bloody world, part aches and sores and wrapping soaking blood, partly fear and glory grown familiar, confined with a shiny fence of swords. And how I learned to love to fence with swords, another world, my homely past and future, once steel and eye and wrist became familiar with each other. Then that steel was almost human, with an altogether human taste for blood. I felt that sword and I could take the world. I felt that Saul and I could take the world, take the whole world hostage with our swords. The bond we felt was stronger than mere blood, though I can see with hindsight in the future, the bond we felt was something only human, a need for love when death becomes familiar. We were wizards, and death was our familiar. Our swords we held, all magic in the world. Richard thought it almost wasn't human, the speed with which we parried others' swords, forever end another's petty future, never scratched, though always steeped in blood. Ambushed in a tavern, splashing ankle deep in blood, fighting back to back in ways familiar, Saul slipped, lost his footing and our future. Broad blade hammered down and sent him from this world. In angry grief I killed that one, then all the other swords, then locked the doors and murdered every human. No choice but to murder every human. No one in that tavern was stranger to blood. To those who live with pikes and slashing swords, the inner parts of men become familiar. Saul's vitals looked like nothing in this world. I had to kill them all to save my future. Saul's vitals were not human, but familiar. He never told me he was from another world. I never told him I was from his future. So there you have it, Joe Haldeman. If you liked what you heard, go check out more of Joe Haldeman, including his great novel, The Forever War, which was easily one of my favorite books of last year. Have a great rest of your Poetry Thursday, BookTube.